Says it can be fatal. But yeah, I'm getting close here. I'm maintaining my C6 point. I don't yet see falling, but it's really teetering. It's on the verge of falling. So my real goal is this guy. But in order to get there, I had to mop up everything back here first. Alright, so Zug says that psychologically he feels defeated or broken. So maybe I've got some chance here. Okay. So apparently, what was his last move? Oh, I'm sorry. A6 is his last move here. I thought he'd moved something. It wasn't until he just played A6 that now a move has been made. How do I improve my position? Like, my targets just keep shifting all over the place. It's really hard to hit them. Alright, A6 is hanging though, so I should take it. Anything else hanging? Alright, so what can't move? This can't move, because it's defending that. So none of these can move. I think that's about the extent of it, though. Everything else is potentially mobile. That's what just has me constantly worried. It would be fantastic if I could vacate both the A and the C files. This is difficult. Which one's easier to vacate? Well, okay, so if he takes, take back. I don't want to weaken any of this. I think this allows me to mop up the most. I'm not at all worried about A7. Not one bit. Okay, so I've got the A file blocked. What a mess. Yeah, I'm gonna learn a thing or two about Horde chess endgames, aren't I? He's gonna take b8. This whole time, everything I'm calculating rides on the fact that I can play d takes c6. And then this is going to release the D pawns and release the Zugzwang. Sounds like Zug's going a bit crazy at the moment. So I have a choice of pawns here. I wanted to vacate the c-file, but I also need to mobilize the bishop. I could actually calculate this out at this point, couldn't I? Might not matter. And I don't even have to take, but taking's the same thing to do here. I'm kind of sort of threatening d5 indirectly. Yeah, my kappa can better defend d7 than my rook can defend b7. Messy. But I think I still maintain my light square complex. Because after he takes there, I could play queen takes c4. Or maybe I just take back on c6, and there's no... Well, no, I should take c4. The c pawns are the most important pawns at the moment. Yeah, it makes me sad to see the doggies go. Poor doggy. I should write a book. Get like $1 billion for writing the book. Alright, well, it looks like my last doggie's gonna go soon. Calculation is difficult. I think the c4 pawn is worth the most of all the pawns. If I take c4, he plays either d7 or c7. Either case, I think I'm covered. Messy. Take c4. And somehow, magically, it looks like my light square complex holds. There was only one doggy left. Long live the doggy. Now, if you place c7, you'll note that all of his pawns will be on dark squares. An interesting tactic, but interesting's about as far as that goes. I wonder what his reaction to this is going to be. Let's listen.
Then we lose all of our stuff. So we have to go here.
Oh, is he going to play d7 after all? Like, that was the move I was least afraid of, but maybe it's what I should have been afraid of. I was expecting c7. Yeah, okay, so he does play c7.
No, I didn't mean to go there.
Yep, no real comment at that point. I suppose what I failed to calculate is this, in combination with I don't know how he's going to get another pawn to, like, harass my... So now he tries for stalemate. We'll see how close he gets. So close. My doggy will live on. Do I do doggy takes, or do I do queen takes? I think I do doggy takes. Yeah! Go doggy, go! It looks like we got this, boys. See, I think his problem is he was too afraid to open the entire board, and like the pieces that I have were equally strong, just latently back here, holding back his entire armada, as they would have been on an open board. Yeah, one doggy survived. And now, Zug gets to savor this for the next 10 minutes while he's playing somebody else, too. I assume there are, like, two players remaining. Yeah, I think I got this at this point. So the point is that queen takes here. Everything's covered. That would be a particularly bad time to pre-move. I think I got this. It is kind of cool how my pieces return to their start squares. Yeah. Awesome. Let's hear Zug's commentary on this game.